Hey guys, and welcome back to another PyQt5 tutorial. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about message boxes, also known as pop-up windows or pop-up boxes. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I've already created a little GUI that just has one button in it that I'm going to use to trigger the pop-up window or the message box, whatever you want to call it. So now I'm actually going to import from the top of this program and go ahead and create the same thing if you want to follow along exactly. The message box class that we need to use. So I'm going to say from pyqt5.qtwidgets import qMessageBox. Now what I'm going to do here is just simply set up a method and link it to that button so that we can use the method to generate a message box when we click on show pop-up. So I'm just going to make this show pop-up like that. We'll give that self pass in here for now, and then we will just connect what we've done 100 times already, that button. So let me say self.button.clicked, like I can spell that correctly, .connect, and then in this case, show pop-up. Okay, sweet. So now in here, we can actually start creating our pop-up box. Now there's a ton of different options that we can use when we're creating this. I'm gonna try to show you most of them so that you guys have an idea of kind of the diversity of it, but our pop-up box will look kind of weird because I'm going to have like a ton of different stuff inside of it. Anyways, what we're going to do is just say message equals Q message box. And this is what we need to do every time that we're going to be showing a message box. We just start by creating an instance of this class, and then we can start calling some methods on it and changing some attributes about the message box itself. So the first thing we probably want to do is change the window title. So to do that, we're going to say msg.setWindowTitle. And then just pass a string in here, which is whatever you want to set. So maybe in my case, I'll just do tutorial on PyQt5. Okay, sweet. Now the next thing that we probably want is the actual text that is going to be displayed in our message box. So to do that, we're going to do msg.setText. And here I'll just say, this is the main text, exclamation point, like that. Okay, now if we want to show our message box, what we do, and I'm going to add some more stuff, but I just want to show you what it looks like right now, is do some variable. I'm just going to call this x is equal to msg.exec underscore bracket bracket. Don't ask me how that works because I don't know, but this is what shows the message box. So anyways, I am going to click Control B to run this. What is the error here? Oh, wow. This is some crazy show pop-up is not defined. Ah, well, that is because I did not put self here. So let's fix that quickly and run it. Okay, so now you see this is our message box. Kind of boring, kind of lame. We probably want to add some stuff to it and make it a little bit more customized. But the two things that we did set, which is the title and the main text, are there. Okay, so now what I'd like to add is actually an icon to our message box. Now there's four different options that we have for an icon, and this is just what's going to show up on the left side, and you'll see what it looks like in the difference between it. But we have warning, critical, question, and information. Those are the four different types of message box icons that PyQt5 has by default. So to set the icon, what we're going to do is go set icon, and we're going to say Q message box dot, and then with the name of one of those things that I listed. So we'll try to start with critical, and you guys will see what that looks like. So let's run that here quickly, and you can see that's that red X, and that's obviously critical, like an error, something happened. If we wanted to do warning, that's going to be that, warning. That's going to be that little triangle. So let's look at that. And then if we want to do something else, maybe information or question, I'll show you what those look like quickly as well. So information, you get the little I there, and question, you're going to get the question mark. So last one here, question, question mark. Awesome. So those are the icons that we can choose from. Now, the next thing that I'm going to show you is how we can change the buttons that show up at the bottom of the message box. So right now we just have OK, which is all right because it just kind of means we're acknowledging the message. But sometimes we want to have the user, we want to ask them some questions, or we want to get some kind of input from them, whatever, with some different types of buttons. So what we need to do is change those buttons. So to do that, we're going to say message.set standard buttons like that. What we're going to do in here is just list the buttons that we want separated by this little line here that I used to know the name of, but for some reason I cannot recall. So anyways, these options here are actually all of the ones I have down here. So okay, open, save, cancel, close, yes, no, abort, retry, ignore. So we can choose between these different buttons. There might be some more, but these are the ones that I'm aware of. So in my case, I'm just gonna choose some random ones. So let's do cancel. We'll put that as the first button. Maybe we'll do retry as one of them. And then the last one, I don't know, let's do ignore. Just to show you three different options there. All right, so now let's run this and see what difference it makes. And now you can see we get those different buttons. Now notice here though, that this first button is actually highlighted blue. And this is gonna be what's the default button for our message box, which means that if I hit enter, that's the one it's actually gonna press. Now that could be troublesome if we don't want that to be the actual default button. As you can see, these aren't really showing up in the correct order that we're typing them in. So what I'm gonna do is show you how to change that, which is really easy, and it's just message box or message.set default button like this. And in here, we just literally copy this name. So maybe I want ignore to be the default button and put it in there. So qMessageBox.ignore. And then you see if we run this now, that ignore is actually that default one that's showing up, right? And that's kind of how that works. All right, so the next stuff that we can show here is how to add some more text. So what's known as the informative text, which is just kind of another line of text that shows beneath that main line as well. So kind of spaces it out. So to do that, we're gonna say message.set informative text like that. And here I'll just say informative text. Yeah, exclamation point. All right, run that. And now you can see we get this little text at the bottom as well. All right, so the last few things to show here are how to add detail text, which is kind of interesting, and how to link up those buttons so we actually know which one's being clicked. So to do this and to add the details, is the first thing we're gonna do is really easy. We're just gonna say message.set detailed text. And then here, whatever text we put here will initially be hidden, and there will be a button that will toggle whether or not we see the details or hide the details. So in this case, I'm just gonna say details. And if I run this, you can see that now we get this button that says show details. And if I click it, it shows details. Otherwise, it hides them. Pretty straightforward. And the last thing that I promised here, which is gonna be how we actually link up these buttons and see which one we click when, you know, we're getting out of the program or when we're going through the message box. So to do that, we're gonna create another method that's gonna be triggered when we click a button. So I'm gonna call this one like pop-up button or something. And what I'm gonna do is just give it self as well as one more parameter here called I. Now you can call this whatever you want, but I is actually gonna be the widget that we clicked. And this is how this kind of works, that this message box is just gonna trigger whenever any button is clicked. It's gonna call this one method and it's gonna pass the button that was clicked. So that way we can see, you know, what the name of the button is, what button it is, and we can do something depending on what that is. So to connect to this kind of pop-up button method, we just say message dot, in this case, I think it's button clicked dot connect. And in this case, we'll just put self dot pop-up button. Now let me check here and make sure that's correct. I think it actually is. And then inside of here, if we want to see what button was pressed, we can print i.txt with these two brackets here. And that's going to return to us the text that's on the button so we know which one we clicked. So let's go ahead and test this now. And if I click ignore, you can see that we print out to the screen ignore. And wow, I have a bunch of main windows open because I guess I haven't been closing them after every time I run them. wow, that's funny. Okay, so that's not super important, but let's close those now. And let's run it one more time and just show a different example. So show pop-up, let's do cancel, and you can see that now it is showing cancel. So that is kind of how you use pop-up windows or message boxes. Pretty straightforward. I hope you guys learned something from this. If you did, make sure you hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel for more awesome PyQt5 content.